We're back with our Oh No's countdown. What if we wanted to make Oh No's guy get bigger as the countdown gets closer to zero to make it seem more like impending doom? One way I could do that is to animate the CSS styles of this image with window.setInterval. For the first step, I'll find the image and store it in a variable. Oh No's equals document.getElementById Oh No's. And I'll set the starting style so it starts off at some width. That way we have something to get bigger from. And now I'll write a make it bigger function. And that will be responsible for making it bigger each time. And in here, we need to change the style.width and take the previous style.width and add one to it. Finally, I'll call setInterval with this function. Window.setInterval, make it bigger. And how much bigger do we want, or how often do we want to make it bigger? Well, we want a smooth animation, which usually means somewhere between 24 frames per second and 60 frames per second. I'll try 30 frames per second, which is 1,000 over 30. Okay, so it's not working. Do you see why? It's a little tricky. So let's go here and think about this. What is the value of ohnos.style.width after this line here? Well, you might think like 50 pix goes to 51 pix, but let's just log out and see what ohnos.style.width is. So we have an info div that we can put this in. So it equals, let's see, 50 pix. Okay. And then we try to add 1 to 50 pix. What is 50 pix plus 1? You might say 51 pix, but JavaScript thinks of 50 pix as a string. So it actually becomes 50 pix 1, which doesn't really make sense. So the browser is probably just ignoring our attempt to set the width property to this nonsensical value. What we need to do is convert this number with a unit to just a number, then add 1 to the number, and then add pix back to it. So we can do that by first wrapping this in parse float, so that turns it into a number, and then we can just wrap all of this, and then we'll plus pix at the end there. Woo! It's working! It's getting bigger! All right. And now you can see the tricky thing about animating CSS properties. They often have these units attached. So you have to parse out that unit. Oh my God, it's getting bigger. You have to parse out that unit and stick the unit back on. Okay, but he's getting really scary. And actually, there are a few scary things about using setInterval to animate CSS properties. First, the browser does not guarantee that it will exactly obey this delay here. If other things pop up, like user interaction, like the user typing, then it might call your callback later, so you won't get this smooth animation. Second, the browser will call your function even if this tab is hidden, which uses up a computer processing power unnecessarily. That's why there's a new function available in modern browsers designed specifically with DOM animations in mind, and is called window.requestanimationframe. To use it, we'll get rid of the setInterval line and call requestAnimationFrame from inside the function, and we'll actually give a reference to the makeItBigger function. And then we'll just call makeItBigger on pageLoad. MakeItBigger. Ooh, all right, wow, it's getting big and really fast this time. The browser is now calling MakeItBigger right before it repaints, which is about 60 frames per second, which is double what we had before. Well, and we're adding 1 pixel to the width each time. And so you do the math, and we're great at math here, then we're adding 60 pixels per second. In just a few seconds, it grows bigger than the page, and now it's gone. How do we slow down our animation? There are a few ways, But one way I like is to keep track of how much time has gone by and then calculate what the new width should be based on that. We start by remembering the start time in milliseconds before the function is called. Var start time, getting bigger again, new date dot get time. And then inside make it bigger, we store the current time. Var cur time equals new date dot get time. And for our calculation, let's say we wanted to grow 30 pixels per second and start it off as 50 pixels. So let's just calculate this here. So new width equals 50, our starting width, plus current time minus start time. That's in milliseconds, so we're going to divide that by 1,000, and then times that by 30, because we want to grow 30 pixels each second. Okay, so that's our new width, and now let's set the style.width to that new width. So new width pix. There we go. That's that nice, smooth 30 pixels per second. And we can, you know, change this number if we want it to grow slower or faster. What about stopping the animation when it gets too big? We can just wrap this line in an if, and this line here, and only do it if the current width is less than some number, like 300. Let's try that. Okay. And now, actually, current width is, new width. Okay, so let's see if it gets 300. Do 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 do. Go, oh no, you can do it. Bah, bah, bah. Beautiful. Now, this technique of using Request Animation Frame should work as long as a user is in Chrome, Firefox, or IE10 Plus. There are various JavaScript libraries and shims that will use Request Animation Frame when it's available, and then fall back to set interval in the older browsers. That's the thing about web development. The web is changing all the time. Browsers are adding new features. Developers are discovering new ways of using those features. You have to be constantly learning about what's new and what's best for what you want to do.